Hello, my dear student friends. Welcome you all to this new chapter, that is morphological image processing. Okay, up till now we have discussed three chapters, right? First is nothing but your fundamentals of image processing. Okay, in that you might have learned about basic fundamentals related to the image processing, how to obtain the images, how to perform some basic operation, let us say finding out the distances and all those things, right? Then we have seen the block diagram of image processing and components involved in it, right? Yes. And in the second chapter, we have gone for gray level transformation, right? In that chapter, we have seen power law transformation, that is linear and non-linear transformations, right? In linear transformation, you have studied about what? Identity and image negation, right? And in non-linear transformation, those are consisting of your power law transformation and log transformation, right? Then we have discussed about gray level transformation, one more type, that is nothing but contrast stretching. Okay, linear contrast stretching, piecewise linear contrast stretching, and all these things we have studied. Then we have gone for the histogram equalization, right? So those things we have discussed in the second chapter. In the third chapter, we have gone for filtering operation, right? So in filtering chapter, we had discussion about both in spatial domain as well as in a frequency domain, right? Now we are going to discuss a very prominent image processing technique in this particular chapter now, okay? So morphological image processing is a very prominent technique which is right now used in many different aspects or in many different fields. Okay, so remember that what is morphology. Okay, so let us understand what is morphology. So morphology, it is a basically a branch of biology, right? Morphology is basically a branch of biology in which it is studied that they are going to study the different structures and designs of animals and plants. Okay, so it is nothing but a branch of, okay, it is a branch of biology which deals with the form and the structure of animals and plants. Okay, so how the plants and how their tissues and all these things are been made, cells and tissues are been made and how they have been formed. Okay, so it deals with that kind of terminology. Okay, and that kind of technique now we are going to implement into the image processing. Okay, so over here, morphological image processing is used to extract the meaningful information from the image. Okay, so let us say we have, I used to tell that you are going to extract the meaningful information from the image, right? For example, let us say let us say a car and vehicle and all these things, or let us say a water bottle, or for example anything you want to extract some of the part of that image. Okay, so for that purpose you can go with this morphological operation. Okay, so by means of morphological operation, definitely you can extract the required object from that particular image, and then you can process, and then you can say that this is nothing but a vehicle, this is nothing but a car, two-wheeler, and all these things, blah blah blah, are there different applications, right? But the thing is that you need to understand what exactly we are going to use, or why we are using this morphology into our image processing, right? So that is the meaning, or that is the advantage why to study this morphological operation in the image processing. Okay, so definitely we are going to extract some meaningful information from that particular whole image, right? And whole image components for representing and description of region. Okay, so we can find out the region, what kind of shape it is, then we can find out the boundaries, then we can go for the skeleton. I hope you understood what is skeleton. Skeleton is nothing but sangada, right? You know that in Marathi, right? So skeleton is nothing but the outer lines, actually we can say that, okay, of different bodies, right? then we can go for the convex hull, all these algorithms that we are going to discuss definitely. Okay, so basically you have studied the set theory, right? So in case of your 11th or 12th, you might have gone for the set theory, right? Or even in case of your digital signal processing, you might have gone for the set theory. So basically morphology is, mathematical morphology is one kind of set theory. So A subset and B subset and all these things, right? So suppose there is a set, let us say S is a set, okay? And the another set is nothing but let us say A, which is subset of, let us say, S. Okay, so like that, you might have discussed about many things, union, then intersection, right? It belongs to, so such kind of operations definitely will be involved in case of mathematical morphology. So remember that basically morphology, that is mathematical morphology, is nothing but a set theory. So you must know each and every fundamental related to the set theory. Okay, so I'm not going to discuss that right now. Okay, so as you are in a final year of your engineering, you must know what is set theory, and there are different rules and the uses or the properties rather we can call. Okay, fine. Then, okay, so we have discussed this definitely. So morphological operation, it is going to provide a unified and powerful approach in image processing. Okay, so in order to extract the images, in order to extract some part of that particular image, and then based on that you are going to go for the further applications in order to provide some let us say automation for the any industry or any home. Okay, fine. So sets represents, let us say a set represent, sorry, so sets represents objects in an image. Okay, so suppose there is an image, right? And let us say this is an object. I am interested to obtain the particular object from that, let us say this whole image. So this is nothing but it is going to have this amount of set only, and it is going to get extracted with the help of this morphological operation. So the sets are going to represent the objects present into that particular image, right? So once we are going to go for the morphological operation, we are going to definitely go into the black and white image. Okay, so it may contain one and zeros, right? So it is nothing but my binary image. So we are going to perform the different operation based on the binary images. Okay, so definitely we are going to go for again thresholding and all these things. You know what exactly the thresholding is. Okay, so how to convert the binary images based on the grayscale images, we know that, right? So based on some certain level, let us say some gray levels are there, that is nothing but 0 to 255 gray levels are there if it is an 8-bit image. Then suppose let us say I have a threshold of 180. If the gray level is less than 180, I am going to mark it as 0, and if it is greater than 180, I am going to mark it as 1. Okay, so like that we can convert the gray level intensity, gray level image into the black and white image, that is binary image. Okay, and based on that we are going to say that, let us say over this is nothing but my boundary of that particular object, and I am going to extract that boundary, and based on that I can go for further processing. Okay, what kind of processing and all these things, that we are going to definitely discuss in this upcoming slides. Okay, so don't worry about it. Great, so let's go to the next slide. I hope the things are clear. Okay, so before going into the depth of your morphological operations, let us discuss some of the preliminaries which are required for the morphological operation. Okay, so remember that reflection, yes. So whenever we are going to take an image, for example, and if I am going to have, let us say I am taking my selfie, and if I am going to use my LED flash, then definitely it is going to create some kind of reflection. Okay, right? So that reflection we are going to check out over here with the help of this one. Okay, so let us say there is a set B, let us say there is my image B, right? And this is actually B cap, not, okay, so, and B cap is denoting the reflection. Okay, so reflection is nothing but simply, let us say this is my image, right? And I'm going to take a reflection. Reflection in the sense, your image, that means whenever you are going to take the selfie, your image is going to get reflected, right? It is going to get rotated, or you can say that it is nothing but a mirror image, right? So this is nothing but a reflection kind of thing, right? So B is okay, let us discuss this equation. So B cap is nothing but W, and the condition is what? W is such a way that it is nothing but reflected, that is nothing but it is a image that is reflected or taken as a mirror image, and the B is nothing but it is belonging to my original image. Okay, so with the help of one example, we will discuss that. Okay, so B is nothing but a set of pixels. Okay, so B is nothing but my actually image, which is nothing but representing. Okay, B, and B cap is nothing but my simply representing an object which is present in the B, and this B we are going to have whose xy coordinates have been replaced by minus of xy, minus x and minus y. Okay, so let us take an example so that you can understand it very well. Okay, suppose this is an my image, and for example, let me draw the what we call, this is x-axis and y-axis, Cartesian graph, and suppose I have an image over here. For example, this is my triangle over here, right? Fine. So what exactly my B cap is? B cap is nothing but this is my original image. Okay, that means original scene, rather we can call. Okay, so once I am going to take the picture of, let us say, selfie, then it is going to get a reflection, and that reflection is nothing but, let us say, this is nothing but x and y now. Okay, so over here x is positive, right, and y is minus, right? It is in the first, second, third and fourth quadrant, right? So right now it is in the fourth quadrant. So I'm going, right now this is having x comma minus y. Okay, right now these coordinates are nothing but, let us say, x comma minus y. Okay, and once I'm going to rotate or get a reflection of that, then this is my B cap is nothing but it has minus of x and minus of y. That means right now x and y, x and minus y are there, so B cap I'm going to get is nothing but minus x, and minus of minus y is nothing but becoming plus y. Okay, so at which quadrant it will occur? It will occur on this quadrant, right? Second quadrant, isn't it? So in this quadrant my image will be appearing. So once I am going to take the image, definitely the image will look like this. Okay, so this is nothing but actually the meaning of reflection. I hope you got this. Okay, that means B cap is nothing but simply the set of points present in B, but whose coordinates x and y have been replaced by minus of x and minus of y, right? So this operation we are going to perform, or it will be performed whenever we are going to have a reflection of your scene into the camera, right? So remember this one. Okay, fine. Then we had a discussion about translation. What do you mean by translation? Translation is nothing but, let us say, moving an object, or let us say moving certain pixels from one point to another point. I hope we had a discussion about, let us say, this kind of object, right? Right, and it was consisting of some 2, 4, let us say again 4 and 2, and it is, let us say, translated by 2, 2, right? It is translated by 2, 2. Then in every coordinate we are going to add 2, 2. So let us say this is nothing but my coordinate 2, 4, this is nothing but my coordinate 4, 4, right? This is nothing but my coordinate 2, 4, sorry, 4, 2, right? And this is 2, 2. So in each coordinate, if I'm going to add, then add 2 comma 2, then it is going to become, so in this, if I'm going to add 2 comma 2, then it is nothing but 4 comma 2, starting with 4 comma 4, right? Then this coordinate is nothing but 4 plus 2, 6, okay? And 6 plus 2, 4, sorry, 2 plus 2, 4, right? Yes. Similarly, in this as well, 2 plus 4, sorry, 2 plus 4, it is going to become, 2, and this 4, it is going to get added. 2 plus 2 is becoming 4, and this 4 plus 2, it is going to become 6, right? So this we had a discussion already, right? So rotated by something, some angle, and translated by some amount, okay? So over here, 6 comma 6. So this kind of translation and rotation we had a discussion about in a in the first or second chapter, I don't remember exactly right now, okay? So this is nothing but simply having some coordinate which are going to get added into this B image, okay? So suppose my image is there, for example, okay? So this is nothing but my quadrant, and let us take again that similar kind of triangle is there. And if I want to translate that triangle, for example, I don't want this at origin, I want it at certain different coordinates. So these are nothing but my coordinates, that is nothing but, let us say this is z1, this is z2, right? So these are the coordinates by which we have translated that image, okay? So this, let us say 2 comma 2, this is nothing but, z1 is nothing but 2, and z2 is also 2. So it is added with 2 comma 2, each and every coordinate is now getting added with 2 comma 2, got it? So this image has been translated by z1 and z2, right? And that it is representing. So bz is nothing but my translated image, which is representing that some c variables or some c coordinates, such that c is nothing but a translation of b, that is object, plus some coordinate, translation coordinates, right? And that is nothing but, and the b is belonging to my original image. B is nothing but my some part of that image, okay? So this is my total b, and this is nothing but my some part of that image, right? Remember this one. So b belongs to capital B, means this is a part of image, okay? And this is my original image, right? So that's why it is nothing but this kind of belongs to, right? I hope you know the what is the meaning of belongs to, okay? So it is the some part of that B image, okay? Fine. So let us see this again in the example in the next slide. Okay, so check it out. So let us say this is my original image, right? And this is nothing but my translated image. Okay, so right now this my image is nothing but in the fourth quadrant, right? And if I am going to translate, I am going to take a reflection of this, then definitely it will occur into the second quadrant. Yes or no? Yes. So therefore, remember this one. This is nothing but having x is plus and minus, y is minus, right? Once I am going to convert, that means b cap is nothing but what? B cap is nothing but minus of x and minus of y, okay? So therefore, x is going to become plus and y is, x is going to become minus and y is going to become plus. So it is going to occur into this quadrant, right? Okay, so this is nothing but my reflected image. So this is a reflection operation. So remember that these operations are also important whenever we are going to perform the morphological operation. So these need to be extensively used operation before going for the morphological operations, and that is nothing but based on the structuring element. Okay, so remember that in case of filtering operation, we had talked about this kind of two-dimensional array. In that case, we used to call this as a kernel, template, right? Filter mask. It is one and same thing, right? Over here, as this morphological operation deals with the structure of different animals and plants, so this is nothing but called as structuring element that we will discuss in detail in the further slides. So till then, just be till then forget about this. So remember that this is nothing but again one kind of template or kernel or filter mask. In this case, we are going to call this as a structuring element. That's it, nothing different. Okay, fine. So this is nothing but operation is nothing but a translation operation. Okay, so this image, this is my original image and it has been translated with z1 comma z2 as discussed in the previous slide. Okay, so in this case we have translated that origin from 0,0 to some other values z1 and z2, right? So that is nothing but meaning of translated image. Okay, so over here we are going to use a translation and reflection in case of morphological operation, because as we use to move my filter mask over an image, in a similar manner I am going to move the structuring element. Okay, so that again the mask, the structuring mass rather we can call. Okay, so that structuring mass we are going to move onto the particular image in order to process something or in order to extract the objects from that particular image, right? Okay, so let us take the next preliminary. Okay, so reflection and translation are most extensively used in morphological operation, which is definitely based on the structuring element. So remember that as your morphology deals with structures of animal and plants, so we are going to use that as element. Okay, so structuring element, based on this we are going to process image. So process image with the help of structuring element, right? So remember that definitely we are going to use the structuring element to process the element, the image. Okay, so let us understand what exactly the meaning of structuring element. The structuring element is again a small set or sub images which can be used to probe an image under study for properties of interest. Suppose we are interested in to find out this area. Okay, so this is again having some, let us say, a small area. Okay, so some small structuring element is there, let us say small set, and we are going to impose that onto this particular original image which is under study, right? And what is our area of interest in order to find this area? So we are interested to extract that amount of area only, and we are going to scan this structuring element over that particular image, and we are going to extract those many interested pixels only with the help of this structuring element. That is the meaning of this structuring element. So remember that structuring element is a very similar kind of thing as like that of your filter mask. So as we use to move the filter mask from pixel to pixel from your original image, in a similar manner we are going to rotate or move that structuring element over and over each and every pixel of our total image, and out of that total image we are going to extract some interested area and with the help of this structuring element we are going to extract it. Okay, I hope the thing is clear with this structuring element. Okay, fine. Now let us check out what is exactly the type of structuring element. So as like your filter mask, we must have some origin, right? So if not defined, then definitely it is nothing but present at the center. Okay, if not defined, it is definitely present at the center. So right now this is nothing but my one kind of structuring element. So these are the different types of structuring elements. Okay, you can take any type of structuring element. Okay, so this is nothing but one kind of structuring element which is representing a plus type of a sign, right? Then this is a rectangular, or rather we can call it is a square type of structuring element. This is one dimensional structuring element, right? It is representing only column. Okay, so 1D array. Okay, so this is 2D array, right? Fine. And this is a different kind of again structuring element, right? But if I want to use these structuring arrays over an image, it must be a rectangular, it must be in a rectangular shape. That is the condition. Okay, so if I'm going to use this kind of structuring element into my morphological processing, I need to convert that into this kind of structuring element so that it can have a rectangular shape. Okay, so it must have a rectangular shape. That is the most important thing. If I don't have the rectangular shape, I cannot process the image properly. Okay, fine. So what is the basic fundamental behind it? So remember that this is nothing but my foreground or structuring the value of image or pixel present as like that of structuring element, and this is nothing but my background. Okay, so this is background pixel. Okay, so right now it is white, so this is representing white. Okay, so this is nothing but a foreground and this is nothing but background. Okay, so we are going to consider background pixels as my pixels present into that structuring element. Okay, so similarly, if my image is having some kind of, let us say this is nothing but my image. Okay, so let us say this is my image, I need to process this one. No, so I need to have these as a background elements. Okay, so I will consider the background elements and I will take it. Okay, so remember that we must have the structuring element in the form of rectangular shape. Okay, fine. So again, this is converted. No need to convert this structuring element into the rectangular shape. Already it is in a rectangular shape, right? This is a one dimensional array, also it is in a rectangular shape, so no need to convert. But this we need to convert it, right? So for that we are going to draw this kind of thing. Sorry. Okay, so like this I can draw. Okay, and the rest of others are nothing but the background pixels, right? So these are nothing but the background pixel, and likewise it has created this image or structuring element. Okay, so this is a some small part, small set or part. Okay, is that fine? Okay, great. Okay, I hope you understood this one. Okay, so let us understand. So this is nothing but my image. Image is nothing but my A. Okay, so accommodate the entire structuring element. In order to accommodate the entire structuring element, first we need to convert that structuring element into the rectangular shape, right? So we have converted original B, structuring element into the rectangular shape, and this is nothing but my image, but roll over this structuring element through this area. So I need to consider the background elements as well. So in order to consider this, if the center is going to lie at this position, I need to have these as a background elements, right? So for that purpose, this image has been, or the boundary of that particular image has been increased by considering the background elements. Is that fine? Okay. And this structuring element is now going to roll over. Let us say first this element will be considered, then this, then so on. Okay. So row by column, and then we'll proceed to the further row. Right. So as we used to go for the just like of your filtering in a special domain. So in a similar manner, this structuring element is also going to traverse on that particular image, and how we are going to extract that particular part that we are going to deal in the upcoming sessions. Okay, so I hope you understood everything in this particular lecture, right? And then we'll stop over here, and we'll continue in the next lecture. Is that fine? So thanks for watching.